ladies and gentlemen. He's a child of God, a husband, NRA conservative, radical right-wing supervillain, and Twitter rock star. American by birth, Texan by choice, and a badass by nature. He's the owner of TomOHalloran.com, OHalloranMedia.com, and PatriotRadio.net. Please welcome Tom O'Halloran. And welcome to the fastest hour in radio. This is the Monday night edition of the Patriot Radio Show. I'm your host, Tom O'Halloran. And I'm broadcasting tonight from my underground bunker deep in Arkansas, Brascarado. And I'm here to educate, irritate, and agitate. And folks, I promise you by the time this hour's over, you will have 100% agitation or you'll get double your money back on the way out the door. Please, follow us on Twitter. Currently, our Twitter account is Sir_TPOHisself. Again, my name is Tom O'Halloran. My primary blog is TomOHalloran.com. When you get there, be sure to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Spreaker, any other social media that you fancy. Also, please be sure to follow my editor, Veronica Coffin. Veronica manages 15 websites on our network, and without her doing that, I wouldn't be able to do this. Please find your way to our Facebook page. It's facebook.com/Patriot Radio Show. And like us while you're there. I'm on the air three nights a week, but there's been a change up. I used to be Tuesday and Wednesday. Now I'm Monday and Wednesday for the Patriot Radio Show. And at the same time on Friday, it's Jihad on America, where I cover the Islamists in America. I tell you who they are, what they want, and why you should be afraid. Each week we continue pulling back the mask of Islam, looking at what's being done in the name of Allah, both here and abroad. And I do the news about Islam around the world because it's a glimpse into the future of America if we allow the cancer of Islam to spread here in the homeland. If you did not catch my show on the Muslim Brotherhood, my show Islam is Not a Religion, or my show on Islamophobia, please find your way to PatriotRadioShow.com and check out these three shows as a very basic underlying understanding of the situation. It'll also give you a good foundation upon which we build each and every Friday at Jihad on America. Keep abreast of my shows, listen to the live stream, as well as archives of any shows that you may have missed, all at PatriotRadioShow.com. I'd like to thank my sponsor, the Knights of Templar. Templar Knights, the Military Order of Solomon's Temple. You can find the website at moost.org. I have been fighting the fight against Islam for many, many months. And sometimes it feels like I'm fighting the fight on my own. But when I was contacted by the Templar Knights several weeks ago, it sounded interesting. I've looked into it. It's a great organization. They've been fighting Islam for 1,400 years. I'm with a great order, the Military Order of Solomon's Temple, a great group of people. They're strong in the UK. They're growing here in America. And I no longer have the feeling that I'm fighting the fight against evil by myself. But I'm part of an army. They're known as the Warriors of Christ. It may not be what you're looking for, but then again, it just may. So please, go to moost.org and check them out. Tonight starts a new chapter in my radio show. I've been doing this show on air at KCAA AM 1050 out of Southern California. I'm going to a web-based format now. I don't have to worry about what advertisers will or will not allow me to say on the air. I can say what I want against the administration. I can rant and rail. I can say what I want about the Islamists trying to take over America. I don't have the FCC regulations or station requirements to stay within. So as much as I told it like it was before, you will hear more and more of my own voice as we go forward, because I'm no longer bound by station guidelines. I'd like to welcome Ron Gulf Dogs on Twitter. Ron is a dear friend of mine. He's been a supporter. He's been in my chat room since I started the show, him and several others, who will probably be showing up a little bit later. They're not used to the Monday night schedule. But thanks for finding your way here. So we will have some sponsors as we go forward. For the first while, we'll probably end up having a lot of public service announcements, just so that I can take a break every now and then and catch my breath. But for tonight, we're going to run the straight hour right on through. And the show will adapt as we move along. My show is at thepatriotradioshow.com. And if you're listening, find your way to the chat room. Scroll down just a little bit. Find the chat room. Log in and be a part of the conversation. There will be a call-in number in short order. We're still working out some of the details on that. It may be a Skype interface. It may be a like a Google number or something. For the time being, we're without the call-in option. But that is, as I said, short-lived. Okay, we're going to start tonight out with several stories to cover. I was running late with a conference call regarding the Republic of Texas. Let's talk about the Republic of Texas for a little bit. I had a guest on a couple of weeks ago. I took 2 weeks off because I was very, very ill with a cold, and I just had no voice left. So I took a couple of weeks off. But just before I left, I had Ed Brenner from the Republic of Texas join me. The Republic will be a recurring feature on this show. On the first Tuesday of each month, I'll be having somebody from the Republic on, and we'll talk about what's happening, where we're going, and what the updates are. Some of you may remember we had a Republic of Texas meeting. It's basically a congressional meeting where the Congress and the Senate meet. Several of us are officers in the executive branch of the Republic of Texas. We were all in attendance. And about 5 minutes into our meeting, 15 sheriffs from five counties, representatives from the Texas Attorney General's Office, the Texas Rangers, the U.S. Marshals, and the FBI all raided the joint. We were taken out of the meeting room and into the big hall, and one by one we were interviewed, photographed, fingerprinted, and they wanted to do a mouth swab, but they didn't get anybody to go along with that. There are some lines. Then they took all of our cell phones, our laptops, any personal papers that we had on us. If you're interested in reading about the raid, our website is thetexasrepublic.com. Find your way there. It's real easy to find the stories. We've been picked up by several newspapers. A New York Times article came out just today. WorldNet Daily came out on the 2nd of March, and we had 5,200 people hit our website that day. Today it was the New York Times, and there were about 1,100 people more than that. So it was our greatest web viewing of the history of the Republic, actually. We're getting quite a bit of visibility. The outpouring of support for what happened is phenomenal. Nearly everybody has been supportive of the Republic of Texas. Whether people support the belief that Texas is still a republic or not, and we can get into that, we will get into that in the weeks and months to come, but whether you embrace the idea that there were flaws in the merging of the Republic of Texas into the United States, whether there were flaws in that or not, what we had were 40 civilians, 40 people, whether you call us Americans, Texans, or Texians, which is what we go by in the Republic. There were 40 individuals in a room, peacefully assembling. Now, we in the room don't consider ourselves Americans. We believe we belong to the Republic of Texas. It's a country unto itself. But even if you don't believe that, and you consider us Americans, there were 40 Americans sitting in a room having a peaceful assembly, guaranteed by the Constitution, by the Bill of Rights, our right to free speech, our right to peaceful assembly. And yet we were raided. The police were serving a search warrant that had two people named. And in the search warrant, a judge authorized the confiscation of everybody's cell phones, personal records, briefcases, laptop computers. Everything. Never mind that the entire thing was against the law in the Republic of Texas. It was patently against the law in the United States as well. And I'm sure lawsuits and criminal charges will probably be filed for weeks and months to come. We were held against our will. Whether you call it arrest or kidnapping, we were illegally held and kept from going anywhere, even though we had done nothing wrong and they had no reason to believe, reasonable reason or not, they had no reason to believe that any of us had. They were fishing. So this show is not about the raid. It's not really about the Republic of Texas. I'm just giving you a little bit of an update. It has made national and international news. When the New York Times article hit today, our president, President John Jarnicki, was called and interviewed by an Italian media operation. And we will have international press forthwith, I would expect. And it should get international press because it's an international issue between two nations. Between one organization, whether it's a state that's desiring to become a nation or whether it's already a nation, the right of the people to govern themselves. Read about the Republic of Texas. Feel free to come up and join us. Our next meeting is in Waco, Texas, this coming Saturday. Meeting starts about 9:30, and the meeting place is on the website. It's called The Republic of Texas. No, I'm sorry. It's thetexasrepublic.com. thetexasrepublic.com. Okay, let's move on, get on to some political topics of an American nature. The media seems to be really cheering on this whole Obamacare. As the cases come to the Supreme Court, all you see or hear in the media is talking about how great Obamacare is, how well it's being rolled out, how there are 8 million people that are on board and it's working so well. The numbers are all cooked. If you dig past the spin, you will easily see that the numbers aren't nearly what they say they are, and they're trying to totally gloss over the fact that the subsidies are only supposed to be for states that have state-sponsored pools where they have state-sponsored broker houses to get your insurance from. Many of them don't. And when the ruling comes out that those people cannot get the subsidies, prices are going to skyrocket. Some people won't be able to get